So one of the first things you want to do to really be successful in cybersecurity is you really need to know yourself as much as possible. You need to know the risks. You need to do either an internal risk assessment. You need to do some analysis on your own environment. You need to understand your vulnerabilities. You need to make sure that you're looking at your vulnerabilities, doing scans or something to understand what you're vulnerable. And you need to make sure you have plans of how you're going to fill that in on a regular basis. If you don't know your own vulnerabilities or weaknesses, the bad guys are going to figure it out. So this is one of the things you want to make sure you do. And if you do get breached, do you have a plan in place of how to respond quickly to the threats when they happen? And do you have someone that you can work with to be able to respond to it as well? You got to make sure they have all the information so you know what to do when something actually does happen. So to know your adversary, you really need to know exactly who they are. So here's a couple of ones that we can talk about, and a lot of these are pretty much pretty easy to understand. The first one is the individuals. And this is usually where the commodity and the like a broad attack. Basically, what I would say, these are the ones who are probably the students who are learning to build their portfolio on how to actually get access to certain things. Or it could be people who are trying things out like it's a game almost, where they're actually trying to get access to certain environments. And so those are the ones that you probably can protect and block through your standard malware, standard antivirus and certain things, but you still got to make sure because they're doing damages to a lot of the universities and a lot of the cities and a lot of schools because they're the practice zones. Next, you're looking at the hacktivists. This is where they're actually motivated by trying to basically take over to inflict harm and basically do something to basically ruin the reputation. So the goal here is to figure out what we can do to basically break you down and take you out. We're seeing a lot of this, and this is starting to now turn into a lot of politics as well, as you know, where all things are happening right now because of this. The next one is organized crime. Money is the dollar sign. That's what they're focusing right now, is how can they turn this hack into money? And all they're doing is figuring out how and what they can do to actually gain that money. This is just one example that you can do to really kind of help look at the different types of attacks. This is one attack that happened recently. Basically, they were compromised, and they actually waited a full month before they did anything. They got access, they waited a month, and then after they finally turned it back on, they basically then were able to access the data within 2 weeks. But they still had to go through a process to get through it. So if you can understand, you need to figure out how to stop them right in the beginning before they get there and sit there from the beginning. So there's a few ways that you can do this. This is just the first 6 hours. In the first 6 hours, you can basically see that this hacker had to go through multiple ways of getting access to that information just to compromise the system and then finally turn themselves off. If you can basically put in a place to block each of these different areas, or at least be notified that something happened that looks suspicious, now you can be at least have an early warning detection system that tells you, okay, something's not right. Here's the six different ways that you could have detected it just from the first 6 hours. This is just one example. Understanding your threat actor and knowing what they go after. A lot of times what we found is that when we see an attack, that if you understand the threat actor, we can understand what they're going after right away. A good example is understanding the threat actor. The threat actor goes after a certain motive, and that motive goes through and basically has an access to certain people. It goes to certain tradecraft and goes through the process, and they always go after the data. And we've noticed that a lot of times that same actor has the same process over and over. So if you understand that process and what they're after, then right away, if all of a sudden you get a detection, you find out that's the person that you're after, you can already see right away what they're after. It's not always perfect. There's not a perfect science on this, but that's why you need to understand the bad guys and what they're trying to get access to, because there's so many different ways to get through there. So now that you understand a little bit of that information, what do you do with all this knowledge, all this intelligence? You still need to make sure you put a plan together. Once you actually have the ability to get the visibility, which means you have the alerts, you're now getting some notifications, you actually have a team that can actually help you. It could be just one person doing it all, right? But at least you have a plan of what you want to do. Next, you want to make sure you put a process in place that you can then handle this. Because if you don't have a process and a plan, guess what? All of a sudden these alerts are going to come up and you're going to go, I don't have time to work on that because I have all these other things to do. You got to make sure you have time to respond to those alerts when they happen. So you want to put it in place to be able to make sense of the data. You have to be able to have someone who's going to help you detect the threats when they come up, or at least some suspicious activities. But then you need to validate it. Is this a false positive, or is it true? Do I have to really do something about it? You need to know that difference. If you can't guarantee if it's a false positive or if it's a true attack, then what are you going to do with it? You got to find a way to be able to analyze that, and that's where the triage comes in place, to be able to know that. Then you need to decide, okay, yes, this is bad. What are we going to do to contain it? You need to have a plan of what you're going to do and how you're going to do that, or have something with it, and then eradication. How do you get it out without damaging everything else? I always like to ask the guy to Ray, when if you've had it, first of all, no one likes to answer this question, but has anybody been attacked recently with ransomware or with any type of breach? Liars. So I always like to ask, if it did happen to you, what would be your first thing to do? Would you unplug the internet? Would you unplug the power? Is that one of the first things you guys do? Or what were the things? Most people say they unplug the power and the internet right away. Guess what? When you unplug the power, you just cleared up the memory. And now you just basically, most attacks now, they put it in the memory now, not in the hard drive, because they know you're going to unplug it. So they want you to maybe unplug that, and you lose all the memory. So right away, don't unplug it. There's a way that you can actually copy the memory, get that knowledge first, and then save that, and then start doing some analysis. And that's just a basic thing that you can even have your tech guys do that's not even security related. But you got to have the process to know how to do that. So you contain it. Then you want to basically eradicate it. There's a whole process that you have to get to know, but you got to make sure you have a plan of how to eradicate it. And then you want to learn from that. What exactly happened, why it happened, who it was, what do we need to do to protect ourselves, and then use that knowledge to prevent it. What we've seen is that all this work goes through this process, and then guess what? They don't use that information to prevent it next time, and it happens again. The last thing you want to do is to have it a second time, because you can't explain that. The first time is like, well, something's happened. The second time, no. So here's some basic things you can do right now to at least start the process. You want to first understand yourself, so you want to start doing those assessments. You want to basically do some penetration testing. You also want to do some security awareness training. And then at the last, you make sure that you have an incident response plan in place as well. These are some basic things that you can do right away to get things started. And here's what my crawl, walk, and run kind of plan. That you can't do everything right away. There's no money. We understand that. So the goal is what are some small things you can do now and then put a plan in place for the next 5 years. And so what we at SecureWorks, we try to do is try to figure out exactly what you can do now for the smallest amount of money, but the biggest bang, and then could have put a plan together to help you maintain that. And this is just some examples, some of the things you can do. And always remember, everything you're doing, also keep in mind, if you're going to the cloud, what's your security plan for the cloud? Just because you're going to AWS or some other cloud service does not mean there's going to be security in mind. You have to make sure you put that plan around in place as well. Perfect. So one thing I wanted to make sure I say is that there's so much things going on. There are so many things that are going on in the marketplace. But if you understand some of the processes, some of the things that are going on, you can better have a plan. Again, understand yourself, understand the bad guys, and put a plan together so you can really focus on putting your cybersecurity plan together.